Here I am backstage at Arctangent Festival with Pigs on a Baylor hat. You wear better to me.
Yeah, it's where I'm most comfortable.
It is a farm here after all, so it's pretty fitting.
It is.
Actually, why are we talking about pigs? Why pigs? Why not cows, chickens, ducks? Why pigs?
Well, you're assuming there's some sort of rhyme or reason to our band name.
Yeah.
There isn't.
I did hear a rumour that you got sick of people asking what you did for a job, so it come up as a joke with a long name, so that every time you describe it, it's a ball.
If that's what you've read, then...
That's what a reliable friend told
me. Yeah. You can believe that if you want.
Yeah. We'll believe anything, that's why. Anything you say. But yeah, you're playing, top of the stage today.
Yeah.
Tangent
Festival,
that's amazing.
It is. I think someone's made... serious admin error.
But it must be great to return to a festival and then be topping the stage, having played lower down earlier on.
It is nice. Like, this is one of our favourites as well. Like, I think this is our third time playing here.
I think so, yeah. It's been a lot, anyway.
Yeah, the previous couple of times have been like super memorable. So, like you say, if you're headlining the stage, it's that's perfect.
Yeah, it's been a good year for you, festival.
It's been all right. Like we've done a lot of touring this year since the album came out. We've pretty much toured solidly from middle of February through the start of June. So this festival season, by design, has been a little bit quieter than last year. Last year's festival season was like mad busy. We were away like every weekend throughout the summer. But we kind of figured this festival season, after the amount of touring that we've done, maybe you need a little bit of rest. So we've been a little bit more selective this year.
How many tunes would you play today?
I guess availability,
logistics, right?
And logistics.
If I'm aware, my manager,
Just as like Southwest off who we were prepping to go. Our flights were in like 2 or 3 days' time or something, and the news was kind of breaking that something quite serious was happening. But at that point, like, no one really understood what was going on.
I thought it's been a matter of weeks at that point,
isn't it? It was a really, really strange and quite stressful time. But it was nice to be able to have the opportunity to, it all came back round again for us, which really, really grateful for.
Yeah. One of the really cool things you got to do there was a podcast with Paul Shaw, like 90s cult icon Paul Shaw.
Yeah.
How was that experience?
Really bizarre, very surreal. And it was part of me that hoped it wouldn't go online.
Right.
But there was also part of me that hoped it would as well. Yeah. So, it was very, very odd. But it was an experience.
Paulie Shaw is going to be an experience.
Yeah.
Was he everything you expected he would be?
Yeah.
Brilliant. Well, you've got a UK tour coming up later on this year. You've got a massive US tour as well coming up.
Yeah.
Exciting stuff. Are they all?
It's good. It's good. Like I said, to be able to pick things up where we left them off, in 2020, I think we'd be fortunate and blessed to be able to do that. And this year so far, it's been like a bit of a I was singing this morning, when I was in the car driving to our practice space to get the gear. I was at one point this year, I'm going to have a moment of being able to reflect on everything we've done this year, because we've also got some more stuff coming up towards the end of the year, which we haven't announced yet. And I think by the time we get to the end of the year, I do want to have a bit of a moment for myself to kind of look back over it all. It's going to be overwhelming, but it's just been like, I don't know, I suppose it's been like
a lot of what I've ever dreamed of doing, really.
Yeah, so,
it's like, you know, we played together with Arctangent. Got music from America, came back.
You're
American,
yeah.
Likewise, in Australia, went off to Australia.
Wow, so,
never would have assumed it. It's one thing we're good at, and the other thing is all right.
That's all right.
Good at not taking things for granted. We have to kind of slap ourselves quite often.
Easy for it just to roll, isn't it? It's studio tour, promotion, all that kind of thing.
Yeah, it's pretty relentless.
But I think, it's nice job. It's kind of, we constantly find ourselves in these different situations where I'm just like, Colin.
It's cowboy world.
Yeah,
right.
But the horse has bolted. Just how the fuck have we ended up here? Like, what is going on? It feels very, very surreal at times, but it's important to kind of try to register what's going on and just kind of appreciate the moment.
What are you going to do in that answer? Like, how are you going to reflect on it? What are you doing? Go and make that answer.
Just
lay at home.
I'm just basically trying to catch up on as much sleep as possible. I'll just be lying in bed for like 2 weeks.
Just Netflix on repeat, catch up on everything.
We did a nice thing at the end of like the first half of this year, whether we're coming back after the last gig we did in mainland Europe, which was kind of the last of the like hardcore touring sessions that we've done with our sound engineer. We ran through every single gig that we played since the start of February and gave a little comment or a little memory on what we did. I mean, it was
like a sports team at the end of the season taking stock of like the key games.
As we got about three quarters of the way through the gigs, it was just like, oh yeah, that was a good gig, and I ate a really nice burger. And then the next show, Johnny was like, oh, I had a really nice kebab that night, and yeah, the show was pretty good. And that was it.
I didn't hit a flat note that night.
Johnny must have had about 40 kebabs.
Kebabs over Europe.
Looking for sponsorship.
German doner kebab.
All
the kebabs available.
Yeah. Exactly.
Guys, thanks so much for joining me. I'm looking forward to the show later.